Today we're going to be playing Assassin's Creed III Remastered. This one personally was one of my favorites. I know a lot of people didn't like this one, but I did. I was about a senior, I think, when this came out. The Assassin's Creed series in general, I enjoy. I remember in 8th grade, in junior high, before I had my license, Assassin's Creed 2 came out. I faked being sick, drove down Interstate 25 to Walmart, where I convinced my second cousin cashier that I was whatever the you how old you need to be, 18 or whatever, mature enough to buy the game. And I bought the game and got a pack of donuts and I think a pack of soda and drove back down the interstate in my mother's white 99 stick shift Saturn and played Assassin's Creed 2, the first game I ever bought. Really, with my new Xbox 360, was Assassin's Creed. And I remember my mom was pissed that day. I spent all my money on an Xbox 360, but hey, here we are playing the third one, and let's get into it. Updated menu. Does this one come with the remastered version? If so, cool. I've never played it, and I will play that. Let's jump into Assassin's Creed 3. I remember the intro was a little long last time, so the sooner we jump into it and get to the assassin stuff, the better. Okay, this looks. Hopefully, we have that with the remastered version. It was $10, folks, on the PlayStation Network. Go ahead and grab that game just because. What's this fucking guy's name? Connor. That's his name.
Used to be when people talked about the end of the world, we locked them up or laughed them off. Sometimes both. But we never took them seriously. Maybe we should have. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Better to start at the beginning with the abduction of Desmond Miles, my son. This boy had no ambition, no direction, no plans for the future. What he did have was a heritage, one he chose to deny. It nearly cost him his life. He was captured and imprisoned. Those who took him believed he could help them find something. The apple. One of several artifacts we call pieces of Eden. Bits of ancient technology scattered across the globe. Some hidden, some found, all of them dangerous. Most are held by a single group, the same group that now had Desmond. You know them as Abstergo Industries. We know them as the Templars. As the enemy. We've been fighting them for thousands of years.
The Masons.
Even longer if you believe the stories of their origins. I do. After all, I've seen the truth. That's the beauty and the horror of the Animus. A device that allows us to enter and experience the lives of our ancestors. It holds the power to change everything, to show us history the way it really happened. Up until its creation, to the victor went the spoils, went the truth. We're trying to fix that, to free minds and bodies both. But there's only so much that we can do, and the Templars have the upper hand these days. But something larger than the Assassins and Templars is approaching, bigger than all of us. And if we can't find a way to stop it, these next few weeks will probably be our last, everyone's last. In the end, it all comes down to him, to Desmond. Through the Animus, he discovered his heritage, explored the lives of his ancestors, and uncovered their secrets. When that was done, he trained. He used another ancestor to provide decades of experience in the span of a few days. It worked. We think. We hope. Soon, though, soon we'll know. That ominous date fast approaches, December 21st, 2012. None of us knows what it'll bring, only that this is where they want us to be. When it does. They've been guiding us in their own fractured, frustrating way. These voices from the first civilization, the ones who came before, a precursor race of immense power and uncertain motives. They're the ones who made the pieces of Eden. This is where they've led him, and through him, us. He stands at the entrance to this long-lost place, armed with the knowledge of Altair and the abilities of Ezio. He holds in his hands the apple of Eden, and we stand at his side, ready to support him however we can. His name is Desmond Miles, and he has brought us to the end. We're here. Let's go.
Now, I remember as a kid, you used to hate having to come out of the Animus and play as Desmond. Dude looks like a fucking Christian Bale, Owen Wilson slash... I don't know, man. It'll come to me. Okay. That jawline, though.
In another moment, down went Alice after it, never once considering how in the world she was to get out again.
I like that recap before the gameplay here. I still have no idea what we're doing, though. It's gonna teach me how to play or something.
I think we're here.
It's like an Italian Nicolas Cage or something. I don't know. Yeah. They caught up pretty quick.
Temple triggered a bleeding effect. You collapsed and entered into a fugue state.
So naturally, you dropped me into the Animus instead of, I don't know, making sure I was okay?
Yep.
You weren't in any danger. Besides, the Temple appeared to be communicating with you, and I didn't want to risk severing the connection. At least not until we knew what it wanted.
Right. Of course.
Son, I...
No, it's fine. I get it. And I know what I'm looking for, by the way. It's a key. Just no idea where it is, though. I guess that's why she triggered the bleeding effect.
She?
Juno, Dad. She's talking to me.
Okay.
Okay, Desmond. While you were, visiting Constantinople, we picked up a software update for the Animus. I'd like to run a couple of quick tests, make sure there aren't any major issues.
All right. What do you need me to do?
We'll start simple. Walk to the marker over there. Okay, Desmond. Let's practice climbing on these objects.
I think this game needs a remake. I like it, but I think it would be awesome if they
rerun your way through this little obstacle course
for the newer software.
That's a constraint. These are optional objectives that raise your synchronization rate. All right, Desmond, follow the on-screen instructions and kill the two Templars.
Gotcha. Punk.
All you have to do here is jump the gap.
Said jump the gap. Okay.
Communication levels look good now. We should be able to build the world. Time to find out what the temple wants from you.
Forgot this guy's name. But he is the father of Connor.
Sir? Sir? Everything all right, sir?
Yes, fine.
Ethan.
I'm just preoccupied, that's all.
Don't forget your invitation. Master Birch will be meeting you inside.
Thank you.
Where shall I retrieve you once you're done?
Front of the Opera House. And be quick about it. Don't expect to be here long.
I'll bring her around at once.
That outfit, dude. That's freaking awesome. It probably weighs fucking 40 pounds, though. No, his calves are just yoked under that cloak.
Invitation, please. Shall I take your coat, sir?
Touch it. Haytham.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are requested to kindly find your seats.
This way, sir. To
Good
you.
Evening, sir. This way, please.
Okay. Pardon me.
My apologies.
Excuse me, apologies.
Evening, Haytham.
Reginald?
I can't tell you how happy I was to hear they'd mounted this revival. Gay's best work by far. Have you seen it before?
Once. My father brought me here as a child. Though I remember little of it. I don't suppose tonight will afford me the luxury of a proper viewing either.
No, I'm afraid it won't. On to business then. Do you see him?
Oh, I see him.
Be seated in one of the boxes above.
The stairs are watched. You'll need to find another way up.
So is mine. I already have.
Dude's a killer, man.
For 'tis but fitting that we should protect and encourage cheats, since we live by them.
Sir, lack more that set word of trial comes on in the afternoon.
A thousand pardons. My apologies.
A thousand pardons. That's hilarious. I'll just sneak over here. Alright. I feel like they'll see you, bro. I think it's a good show. No one's paying attention. We'll climb over here so they don't see us. Shit. No, 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 no. A thousand pardons. The funny thing is, it's like nobody over there saw me. That's the guy. He didn't see me? I guess that show is just top tier. Okay. That was a lot easier than Skyrim. I broke like 5 lockpicks. I still didn't figure it out. Easy, bub.
stage fright.
A little Dutch courage up with a bloom in your cheek.
It's a ladder. That's sketchy, man.
Jeremy's really burning up the walls tonight. He's a marvel.
Okay.
Well, not to make them.
If any wench Venus
Hathem. You should have come to me. We would have found another way. Yes. But then you would have known. For what it's worth,
I'm sorry.
As am I.
Well, yeah, that's gonna... He's like, Hathem, I saw you climbing across the opera theater. Honestly, if we gotta play an Assassin's Creed game as this guy, it'd be pretty cool.
The snake slide balcony! Hurry!
Come, please!
Over there! That's the one that was murdered!
That man there! Seize him!
A man was killed in the upper balcony!
I've done no wrong! I swear!
Search him! Any weapons?
It's him.
I beg your pardon.
No pushing, please.
Peace, friends,
please.
There is no
Let
danger.
Us through.
Peace, friends, there is no danger.
I certainly try to remember.
They don't know who did it.
At an opera?
Be careful.
I can't get out of here once more.
A thousand pardons.
It happened
we
right
must
in
leave
that balcony.
At once.
What are those
There's
men doing
about? I'm staying where it's safe.
Peace, friends,
Move.
There is no danger.
Move!
Imbecile!
Where are you going?
I really like the look of this opera theater, like just the red and gold.
I need to get out.
And how was the opera?
Rather dull, truth be told.
Shall we be off, then?
Aye. To Fleet and Bride.
By your command.
Fascinating. Gentlemen, I hold in my hand a key. And if this book is to be believed, it will open the doors of a storehouse built by those who came before.
Ah, yes. Those who ruled, reigned, and vanished from the world. Do we know what it is that will be held within?
It could contain certain knowledge. Perhaps a weapon, or something as yet unknown, unfathomable in its construction and purpose. It could be any of these things, or none of them. They are still an enigma, these precursors. But of one thing I am certain. Whatever waits behind those doors shall prove a great boon to us all.
Or our enemies, should they find it first.
They won't. You've seen to that.
I assume you know where this storehouse is?
Ah, Mr. Harrison.
Gentlemen.
How fair your calculations?
I believe the site lies somewhere within this region.
That's a lot of ground to cover.
My apologies. Were that I could be more accurate.
That's all right. It suffices for a start. And that is why we've called you here, Master Kenway. We'd like for you to travel to America, locate the storehouse, and take possession of its contents.
Master Kenway.
I'm yours to command. Although a job of this magnitude will require more than just myself.
Of course. Upon this paper are the names of 5 men sympathetic to our cause. Each is also uniquely suited to aid you in your endeavor. With them at your side, you will want for nothing.
Well, then I'd best be on my way.
I knew our faith in you was not misplaced. We've booked you passage to Boston. Your ship leaves at dawn. Go forth, Haytham, and bring honor to us all.